We now know the cause of a fatal house fire here at the Cumberland Courts Apartments in Greensboro. Investigators tell me it was a cigarette left burning that claimed the life of 82-year-old Katherine Harris. An elderly woman's apartment now condemned, her life lost inside this charred front room, but not before neighbors heard a desperate call for help.
She was banging on our wall. We can hear through the walls.
Hours later, Harris's neighbors are still haunted by that memory, by the pounding sound that woke them up.
You can't shake what happened last night. You just can't.
Can't shake that they couldn't help, couldn't get through the flames, couldn't save a life.
We couldn't do anything because the fire was just that bad. I'm just glad everybody else made it out safely.
We was asking, you know, is anybody in there? You know, and that's when they was telling us to vacate over here.
Harris's family members arrived on scene in tears, sifting through a life's worth of things most destroyed in a morning. They heard firsthand from fire crews what happened around 1 this morning, that Harris could have been stuck inside the burning apartment for an hour before someone saw flames and called 911.
Our belief is she was deceased at the time our firefighters found her. So we do believe the fire had a substantial head start on us before we got the call this morning.
Crews broke through the windows and roof in a swift 4 minutes after that 911 call. But it was still too late. Assistant Chief David Douglas says a simple sprinkler could have saved Harris's life.
A perfect example of, we have the group most at risk, which is the very old, have a fire. If this unit had been sprinklered, that sprinkler would have put that fire out. This would be a non-event. We would not be having this discussion.
Instead, this family is left with a few pictures and mementos, but without their 82-year-old mother.
I couldn't believe it. I really couldn't believe it.
Just my heart goes out to her family because I know they're hurting.
Harris's family members were too upset to go on camera with me, but they did tell me that she was diagnosed with terminal lung cancer a year ago. She continued to beat the odds as well as doctors' predictions, which makes her death in a cigarette fire today all the more difficult to understand and to cope with. Reporting in Greensboro, I'm Kim Gebbia, WXII 12 News.